we're back. For more Pillars of Eternity, I'm the RPG chick. About to go up to level 3 of this tower. The one in Heritage Hill with the undead things around, and we've got some kind of experiment that ripped a hole in the sky and caused everyone's soul to remain in them, even though their body was dying. Some kind of crazy thing like that.
I'll see what I can find.
So will we all, my friend. So you'll be finding these notes and letters all over the place. Oh. Well, I guess this is the last level. Pretty awesome. Ooh. There's Aldhelm. And this looks familiar, huh? Is he gonna be turned into ash? Okay, we don't have any fog of war here. We can look all over. All I see right now is Aldhelm. And we can look at that thing.
No problem.
Let's try this configuration. Still nothing.
Confounded device. A man hunches over the strange mechanism. I didn't want to click on him, so have one member run forward that will probably be killed. A man hunches over the strange mechanism, his spine a sharp ridge rising from his arched back. He's barely clothed in filthy rags, and the patches of skin you see are mottled green. A spoiled stench emanates from him. Ugh. He's so intent on his work that he doesn't notice you until your shadow falls over him. When he turns and sees you, he snarls and scuttles behind the Aedra pedestal. Only his bared teeth seem to have escaped decay. I guess he brushes his teeth still. His eyes are yellowed and bloodshot, but they flicker with intelligence. He averts his gaze and holds a hand in front of his face. I guess I was so beautiful, I'm blinding you by my beauty, you know.
Shouldn't be here. What do you want?
Number 3. Tell me what happened here.
That's what I'm trying to figure out!
He smashes a fist into the Aedra pillar. His hand makes a crunching noise, but doesn't bleed.
Forgive me! Forgive me.
He covers his face with his other hand. He's fighting his animalistic impulses, I guess.
Research. We came to do research on the tower. Some commission from God. Hardly matters now.
I guess not. He clenches his fists in concentration. Palagina says, given the catastrophe that followed, the commission and your research might matter a great deal. Stick to the present. When did the disaster start?
Something happened on our 11th night.
It was a little calmer.
Lights in the sky and a static charge in the air. But we were so careful. We were staying in the chambers below. Trindig, my assistant, said he saw a robed figure lurking around the tower. Wore a mask. Carried knives at his sides. A trick of shadows,
Rogue?
I told him. The next morning, we felt strange. Like we hadn't eaten in weeks. So dazed that we didn't at first notice the blood around our beds. The strange wounds that had appeared overnight.
And the machine! This cursed spire! Dormant for 2,000 years. Lifeless through hundreds of our experiments. And we wake that morning to find it spinning on its own! On its own! How can we stop what we couldn't start?
Canna says, as exciting as the prospect of a living machine may be, I suspect that, given mention of a machine and a masked figure both, there is another explanation. Exactly what I was thinking, my friend.
Years I've been doing this. Years. I know how these things work, but I don't know how this happened.
He gestures at the streets.
Nowhere to go.
That's the problem. Their souls are trapped here like flies in a jar, clinging to rotting meat.
Number two is funny. Slow down. What does the machine have to do with souls?
No time to slow down! But I can explain. Hold a magnet over iron splinters and they stick, yes?
Mm-hmm.
Rub your hand over weir wool and the hair of your head will follow it. So it is with this machine.
He looks at you and runs his tongue along the edges of his fine, strong teeth. He quickly looks away. You feel hungry?
It has the power to manipulate souls, but why? For what? And how many others lie buried in the ruins of Air Glanfoth? No, no. Focus on this one. It's imprisoned our souls in our bodies. Cut the root between essence and flesh. Left a dwindling soul stuck in a shriveling husk.
What happened to the rest of your team?
By the time I realized what had happened, the district had already been sealed. So we fed when we needed, and locked ourselves in the tower to work.
Fair enough.
And then there came a time when the hunger struck, and there was hardly anyone left.
Oh my god. You ate them. Or they ate themselves, and you ate them, and you're the only one left? So there was a stranger in the tower the night this happened?
I didn't see him. My assistant, he saw him. We laughed. Said he was spooked by the cemetery. Perhaps it was already too late. I don't know what he did. But by morning, the machine was on and we were slain. People were already on the streets, complaining of neighbors and family members acting strangely.
How can I help?
Not your help I need. It's...
He snarls.
Herodin, shrew.
He shivers, scowling.
Squanders her research on frivolities, then refuses to make herself useful. Runes. The runes are the last part of the puzzle. Icantha knows them. She gives them to you, and you can turn the machine off. Release our souls.
Canna says, wait, runes? The Ingwithin runes? She can read them? He speaks of this feat so blandly. Let's talk instead to this Haradan, Theodas. I'll pick her thoughts a time. Eldhem says she wasn't here the night the machine came on, staying with her patron somewhere near. Too good to be burdened with our ignorant company. You're not like the ghouls in the street.
Not yet. But I will be. My body is dead. My soul, imprisoned in this corpse, only makes it seem otherwise. And as the body decays, so does the mind. Until nothing is left but the hunger.
He heaves and retches.
The only way to forestall the process is through a regular infusion of essence. Living flesh is the only ready supply.
I like this. They've actually explained zombies. It's pretty awesome.
I'm not proud of any of it. Hunting men and women in the early days of the affliction. Picking off soldiers that came to investigate. But I'd do it again. I'll do it as long as I must to end this disaster.
One shaky hand scratches at his bare, sore-eaten chest. All right, so you're saying you're doing it for the good of everyone, but you might be just hungry. That too.
You could help. Help me end this. Help me find sustenance.
His eyes glitter and he licks his lips with a cracked and shriveled tongue. I'll get the words from Icantha.
Yes. Icantha. She was here in the district. Probably here still, always prepared. Clever lady, that one. And perhaps you bring me something. Something to keep me sharp. Then I show you a secret about the machine. Something to make you strong.
Huh. I'm not sure if we want something from that machine. Palagina clenches her jaw, her eyes narrowing suspiciously. Descanto. His condition has turned him into little more than an animal. Don't do it. He flinches but attempts a polite smile. Between his ragged lips and large teeth, the effect is disconcerting. Something you need? I should focus. He grips the Adra pillar. Must focus. Who and what are you?
15 years at Brackenbury. 7 tours to the ruins beyond Solace Vale. I'm an animancer. Still an animancer.
He closes his eyes and holds the size of his head. His eyes snap open. His gaze lights on the Adra post with sudden recognition. He starts to turn back to the copper dials. Let's look at this. A jagged Adra pillar, again I'm not sure if it's Adra or Adra, rises in front of you, encased in stonework and run through with copper veins. Unintelligible runes cover the panel. Well, I'm not going to turn the dial, because I don't know what to do, but let's inspect it further. A sunburst of copper filaments surrounds a dial that looks to be about twice the size of a hen's egg. The filaments cross and diverge, ending in bead-tipped nodes. Each wire has a point of origin somewhere along the edge of the dial. Runes are inscribed around the dial. Standing near the device feels like being blown about by a storm gale. The stone steps hum with energy. See if there's anything else to see. I suspect not. Alright, we have to return to, what's her name? Icantha. Oh. The winding staircase runs through the core of the tower, providing access to all levels. Proceed to the bottom. That's a quicker way of getting down. Excuse me, wow. Someday the game's gonna surprise us and have things respawn. I'll be like, hey, you broke the rules. Thought we could just run through. Gonna head back up. Zoop. You there. We will have words with thee, especially Canna.
On your word.
Yeah, you wanted the honors.
You return. What if you come seeking this time?
I need the words that operate the Ingwithin machine in the tower.
That fool Aldhelm. He sent you, didn't he?
Oh boy.
I can hardly believe he's had the cleverness to survive. That simpleton thinks he can understand how to use something without understanding what it is, or why it is.
She laughs, a noise that blends the crunch of dry leaves with something piercing and white-hot. You feel a hot core of pride smoldering at the center of her soul.
He dabbles with ancient and powerful devices, with all the finesse of a blacksmith. He sends you here to petition me for aid after years of disparaging my research. I'll bet he didn't even tell you the tower's name, did he? That's his problem. always looking for solutions without caring for meaning.
She shakes her head as she pokes at the fire with renewed ferocity. The problems in Heritage Hill are bigger than your rivalry, Icantha. What do I care? I prepared myself for an eventuality such as this, and I can assure you those dwindling souls in the streets are beyond caring as well. Her pride burns brighter still. Humble Aldhelm now by demonstrating the value of your research. My silence demonstrates it more succinctly. Your words fan the strange coals at the center of her soul. Tell me the tower's name.
Teir Nowneth. It's called Teir Nowneth. They built the machine atop it to contain souls, hold them in place. But the others I've seen, machines scattered all over the Deerwood, are relays, built to move souls.
Icantha closes her eyes. Her voice is suddenly soothing. She stands and turns to you, wiping parchment-dry hands on her clothes. Where would they move souls? Another mystery. Hypothetically, anywhere they wished. The real question, as always, is why? To intermix them the way a player shuffles his deck, the way a farmer rotates his fields? To collect them like butterflies under glass? To melt them down for raw essence? Unfortunately, I do not know. Why would the Inquithans have wanted to tether souls like this?
Perhaps they didn't. Perhaps that's why they built no other machines like this one. We now see the Inquithans as masters of soul manipulation, but they couldn't have attained their expertise without copious trial and error. Perhaps this was one such experiment.
You seem to know a lot about Teir Nowneth. Nowneth, whatever the hell.
I read the runes like a journal. I understand their meaning. People like Aldhelm try to read them like instructions, and in so doing, they miss their true meaning completely.
Okay. How do you operate the machine atop Teir Nowneth?
Back to these tinkers' concerns. And what would you do with these tethered souls if I told you?
She crosses her arms over her unmoving chest. Okay. I don't know if you guys can see that. I'm not going to change my...
Okay.
I now know that you guys couldn't see the little G-Force thing that popped up. It wanted to change the settings of the game, and I clicked on the little X, and that made the game... Well, it made Fraps crash, which I'm using to recording. And so then I tried to, you know... tab out of the game by hitting the Windows key, or Windows out of the game, and that crashed the game. So I was going to try to restart Fraps. So I had to play this part over again. The game auto-saved, so it had saved right after I went in the house, so all I had to do was go past a few questions, and here we are. What would I do with the tethered souls if I told you? Yeah, I'd harvest them for essence. Destroy them? I'd release them. I'm not sure if that's a good thing, though. But that's what I'm gonna say.
So you say. And just what would you release them to? They'd abandon their existence here for another somewhere else, equally aimless and meaningless.
Is that your opinion? I could help you, but I won't. The pride lodged in her soul flares up, twisting into the shape of something that writhes and squeals within her. Here, I have specimens aplenty, and time enough to observe them all. It's every scientist's dream. My answer is no. Oh, come on, man, I want to make the machine! I want to make the machine! Kenna says, what? But what good is observing all this if you're going to hoard it for yourself? Tell her, Theodess. an entire language at your fingertips, and she hides it away. Extinguish her pride? How exactly? By attacking her? The fate of these trapped souls is more important. They're inconsequential. Their existence means nothing. They don't even understand their predicament, which you and I see so clearly. Her pride blazes on. Through them, I'll accomplish more than any of my peers. And who will know about it? Working on that pride there. The pride thing flickers as the flames around it abate. All I've learned. Years of studying the Ingwithin language. No one understands it better than me. That counts for something. I'm still not sure what one is entails. Extinguishing her pride. Can I do that mentally? Or does that mean we attack her? I don't know. Or does the game choose what I'm going to say or do? I don't know. Knowledge is meaningless unless it's shared. A foolish and false sentiment. Knowledge is meaning. It needs no external purpose. Her pride smolders still. Your opportunities here are finite. One day that knowledge will die with you. I'm really curious about one, but I don't know what that entails, me choosing that. So I don't want to choose something that I have no idea what's going to happen. The pride hisses and sputters. It's little more than an ember now. You're wrong. But there's no conviction in her voice. I'll build it forever. I'll cling to it. That will give me something. Teach me what you know. I'll make sure that it grows and your legacy lives on. Your words finally quench her pride, and all that remains is a blackened, diamond-hard rock. You cast it away where it melts into the darkness. Huh. Some metaphysical stuff going on here.
So be it. My studies and efforts shall grow through yours.
Her voice is calm and quiet.
These are the words you need.
Yay! Her cold, dry fingertips rest on your temples, and you feel her reaching into your mind, forming images from the darkness. Runes flash through your head, but they're no longer just pictures. They have meaning, and you understand them. They're commands. Something triggers in your mind, a distant memory unearthed from a past life long since buried. You can see a vast array of runes, far more than Icantha has shown you, and you know their sound and their meaning and how they fit together. The language of Ingwith once more at your command.
Something has awakened in your mind. You understand far more than I ever did. Take this knowledge, then. And do what you will with Teir, Nowneth. Now that you understand its purpose, it will serve you in whatever way you wish.
Thanks. Kenna says, a speaker of dead tongues now. And so she surpasses 100 frustrated scholars in the matter of a few moments. I don't suppose you could look at a few books for me? I know that's what our companions say, can all just like... They're inserted and no one responds to them in any way, including ourselves. It's interesting, though. I like having our companions with us. Otherwise, if I had all, you know, characters that I had made myself, no one would be saying crap. They'd just be standing around watching. I still don't understand why the Ingwithins would want to build a machine that tethers souls. Perhaps they didn't. Perhaps that's why they built no other machines like this one. We now see the Ingwithins as masters of soul manipulation, but they couldn't have attained their expertise without copious trial and error. Perhaps this was one such experiment. Certainly. Yeah. Remind me, how do you know so much about the tower? The wording is different, so I'm going to go into these again. I read the runes like a journal. I understand their meaning. People like Aldham try to read them like instruction manuals, and in so doing, they miss their true meaning completely. You said that the other towers around the Deerwood were constructed to move souls. Why would the Ingwithans have wanted to do that? Another mystery. Hypothetically, anywhere they wished. The real question, as always, is why? To intermix them the way a player shuffles his deck? The way a farmer rotates his fields? To collect them like butterflies under glass? To melt them down for raw essence? Unfortunately, I do not know. Okay, we've seen that before. Thought she might say something else. What do I do with the tower now that I know these words?
Turn it off, I expect. That will be easy now that you can read the runes. The vessels would still roam, but striking them down would return their essence to the cycle. But be careful. That machine controls hundreds of souls, and that volume of essence could easily overload it. Improperly channeling the essence would destroy the machine along with the souls. It would be a terrible loss for posterity.
Explain how the control words work. Harnessing the power of Teir and Nowneth is about understanding what it was designed to do. You know the words and their meanings. You can speak them, and the tower shall obey. Well, that's all. Thanks. Alright, let's do something about the curse. Thus, make haste back to Teir Nowneth after this loading screeneth. Still here on Dads. But there shouldn't be any. Now, after we destroy them, right, their souls are still in their decaying bodies. But after we destroy them, then what? Where the souls go then? Are they still hanging around inside the destroyed bodies? Or are they free at that point? You mean we can't bypass this? I hear undeads. Really just want, yeah, to the top. Thank you. Should have said it from the door, actually, but, you know. This is the way we got down. We still had to go through the bottom part. Alright, we really don't need this guy. Let's see what he has to say. Aldham looks much worse than before. His rotten flesh hangs loosely, and sores have eaten away patches of skin at his joints. He looks at you with a strange glimmer in his eyes. We were gone like 15 minutes, guy.
Flesh.
Huh. He takes a tentative, scuttling step toward you. He doubles over, coughing up strings of black bile. He seems to have forgotten about you for the moment. Aldham has degenerated significantly. He looks ready to pounce on me when I try to talk to him. If I want his help, I'll need to send a victim to him. I don't think we need his help. A jagged Aedra pillar rises in front of you, encased in stonework, and run through with copper veins. The panel is covered with runes which you can now understand. You recognize words for end and for hold. Dial is currently fixed on hold. You also recognize by an inscription that the manner in which you turn the dial is a means of throttling the device. Overloading the device. Let's choose end. As the command words leave your lips, the dial sinks into the Aedra under your hand. Something like a thunderclap sounds overhead. The glow fades from the machine as it falls dormant. Whoa. Huh. Got some experience. Now what?
Still and silent. It's finally over.
Should I have overloaded the device? I can't even select that now. Now what? I guess we're done.
Still and silent. It's finally over.
Let's go down one level. Let's check it out. I want to look at it in the other. I want to look at it on the second floor. Nothing to look at. How does this change things? We might be surprised. I don't know. Yes, the talk icon. So what happens to the undead things? Emptied of essence, the Aedric contraption is still and quiet. That's a good question. Where did the essence go? Where did the souls go? That's it? Go back and talk to her. Tell her, hey, we shut it off. I mean, that can't be it. There's gotta be something that happened as a result of us shutting that off. I mean, we released the souls, but that was her question. Where did they go to? Where are they now? Living just as meaningless a life, but where? Maybe she'll have further insight. Still wonder if she knows we released her captives. Can't make her happy. She's not here. Where'd she go? I don't know where she is. Is she out looking for her captives? I'm gonna head towards the exit. Oh, not pause. See what happens. Seda. Oh, it's a little girl. For those rich people in the mansion. She says, there's that nice lady who helped me. Justice Hero says, and thank the Iron Arm for it. We'll get you sorted out at the keep. Then they run quickly away.
How do you do?
Okay. Defiance Bay was still eccentric. Oh, Justicia stops us. The tower, it's off. Does this mean the curse on Heritage Hill is lifted? Huh. I better get... Wow, that's selfish. It wasn't a curse, but yes, the district is safe again. I think it'll be some time before anyone will be willing to settle in the district again, but at least we can get started on restoring it. I'm still here on dead things.
Good day, stranger.
Quick look. Still eccentric. First fires, I guess. I'm gonna go to the Knights of the Crucible. I think I'm supposed to talk to what's-his-name. The captain of the guard or whatever his name is. Keep waiting for my reputation to go up, damn it. Well, thanks for watching, everyone. See you next time, and endure. In enduring, grow strong.